Are you interested in creating an in-game economy for your title? Come join me, Joanna Lee, and Thomas Goodschmidt from the Azure PlayFab team. We'll discuss the latest features in Microsoft Azure PlayFab Economy V2 and show you how to use them to create and manage an economy for your cross-platform game. Find out how well it scales as your title grows. Hi, Thomas. Welcome. And how are you doing today?
Hi, Joanna. I'm good. Thanks for having me here.
It's my pleasure to have you here to talk about PlayFab Economy V2. And from the sound of it, V2, it's already the second version. So, you know, what is Economy V2 and how is it different from V1?
We're super excited about PlayFab Economy V2. It's a complete solution to help you create your in-game economy, your in-game stores, and your user-generated content systems. We've rebuilt it from the ground up on the modern Microsoft Azure stack. And it supports features and capabilities that our customers have been asking for, like inventory batch operations and idempotent transactions and support for larger inventories with higher throughput.
It sounds like a huge revamp. Larger inventories, larger catalogs. You know, it has a lot of cool, great new features. For those who aren't familiar with PlayFab Economy V2, could you share with us what are the advantages of using PlayFab Economy V2 versus, you know, building one on their own from scratch?
So it takes a lot of time to build all of those features. Virtual currencies, multiple inventories, support for a large catalog, receipt validation, transaction data. Instead of spending the time to create all of that from scratch, you can use what PlayFab Economy V2 provides out of the box. There are also a lot of hard engineering problems behind services like these. There's scale and reliability and item potency and security and auditing. We've made it possible to just launch your game with a highly reliable and business-ready economy in the cloud. We've helped thousands of games ship already, and you get the benefit of everything we've learned.
Yeah, PlayFab Economy sure offers a lot. Creating a framework like that takes a lot of time. You know, especially you have to build all the functionalities that comes with creating and balancing an economy, right? Like, you know, adding and removing items, you know, adjusting price, you know, over time, you know, over platforms, as well as regions, right? Let me ask you here on behalf of the game designers who are watching these videos, who are thinking about creating in-game economies. We often want to allow players to purchase items, you know, in-game items, right? Using real currency like money. I understand you can use PlayFab Economy V2 and the PlayFab portal to enable this. Could you show us how to allow a player, for example, to buy an in-game item like an exclusive care pack?
Yeah, so we've set up an item type called bundles, which handle this interaction between the real-world platform store and the in-game economy. Let me show you how. First, you set up the game platforms you're going to be using. We have plugins for all the major platforms and marketplaces that games ship on. Once you've set up the platform interactions, you can navigate to the economy section and create a bundle. Yeah. Within the item bundle metadata, you can update the marketplace mapping section to link to a specific platform offer. Although each platform handles these transactions slightly differently, you can set up the offer on the platform, set up the bundle in our catalog, and then use a redeem API to pull it together. We have great step-by-step instructions on Microsoft Learn for setting up these transactions on each platform.
Yeah, this is cool. I can see, you know, PlayFab being used to create an economy model where most of the items are purchased using virtual currencies, and then you create a new item type, right, that allows you to purchase this virtual currencies using real money.
Yeah, and that's how a lot of games will set their economies up. They'll create a small handful of real-world offers on the platform used to purchase virtual currency. Then they'll use virtual currencies to purchase virtual goods and create engagement within the game using a system like PlayFabs.
Yeah, amazing. There's a lot of flexibility for us developers here. I also believe that every item can support multiple currencies as well as multiple prizes. Is that right?
Yeah, that's supported. Our catalog is very flexible and was built with this kind of scenario in mind. Every item can support multiple prices in different currencies. You can also set up item purchases for multiple bunches of currencies. Say you have wood, stone, and gold as your currencies in game. You can have an item that costs 3 of each. We actually just published an article about how to set up crafting scenarios on our Learn site that walks through using prices in just this way.
Yeah, let me switch topics here. I know that Economy V2 is built for scale. So how well equipped is it to, you know, manage hundreds and thousands of items?
So we built PlayFab Economy V2 with scalability in mind. We have partners who have tens of thousands of in-game items, and it can be tricky to manage that many items, especially when you're trying to manage them across multiple platforms. To make the scenario easier, we have an API-first philosophy where every interaction with the catalog can be done programmatically and connected to your local automation or your local build system.
I see. So basically, you can use an API to manage any items, and you can always use code. And so what's the best way to implement a big list of in-game items or, you know, manage large amounts of data on PlayFab? Do you have any best practices or any tools to help us with this?
Yeah, so as your catalog grows, keeping all of these items synced to your game updates can become a data replication issue. We have games that have enabled syncing their items via batch scripts in their build systems or by using an Azure function that is called to make updates using our APIs. We've also invested a lot in our catalog search API to help you manage a large catalog of offers. With customizable content types and customizable tags, you can build tools and in-game views with search that only fetch the content you need.
And so how do you support, like, you know, searching and filtering the catalog, right, using the search API?
So we support a very simple OData-like syntax where you can have queries for filtering and for ordering and sorting the responses. You can also use the select statement there to give you control over fetching only what you need for a particular scenario.
Yeah, I know that PlayFab has a lot of capabilities, but I didn't realize that you also include features, right, for managing and managing and searching for data, right? So I also understand PlayFab Economy supports, you know, many game platforms. So is it actually, you know, cross-platform compatible?
Yeah, we're fully cross-platform. I mean, you can have 800 items in your virtual catalog and you don't need to replicate them on every other platform store. You can link a single PlayFab catalog bundle to multiple different platforms.
Yeah, this is great. You know, I love it when, you know, you can just create it once and you can use it across different stores. Until now, actually, you know, we've been talking a lot about, you know, what PlayFab Economy V2 can do, you know. Could you share with us if there are any limitations, you know, especially if, you know, I'm thinking about building a game that has a huge worldwide player base?
We've spent a lot of engineering time and resources to ensure that PlayFab Economy V2 can scale to AAA games and all sorts of game calling patterns. We support some of the largest in-game economies today. Generally, we default to what customers consider a safe setup that limits reads and searches per player entities and has higher threshold for game entities. You can read about these thresholds at Microsoft Learn.
So, you know, are you essentially saying that, you know, we as game developers don't have to think about limits because you've taken care of it already?
We like to think so. We designed V2 to be able to scale with your game as it grows from a small audience to a large one.
Yeah, this is great to know. I'm glad you have, you know, answered all the questions I have about Economy V2, and thank you for your time here today.
Thanks, Joanna. This was fun.
For those who are watching this video, I hope you've enjoyed this episode. Thank you for joining me on Microsoft Game Dev Connect to learn about using Azure PlayFab Economy V2 to create in-game economies.